giving them the butt. It's so rude.
I said this at the top of the show. I'll say it again now. I've got some rules I try to adhere to when it comes to the show. No kids getting molested. No people getting murdered. Those are not funny things.
No.
This is a funny show, and I don't want to do funny things because it's not funny. There's nothing to laugh at there. And if you are laughing at those things, Jesus Christ, what is wrong with you? Fuck's sake. You're not a good human. You're a bad human. Well, she fucked off.
She just dove like an Olympic swimmer.
Boom!
She caught like she went 5 feet out.
So, given that, normally when I get a list of all the stories for the show, all the research comes in, Catherine and everybody else sends all the stuff in, I have to go through kind of like with my own mental highlighter and go, nope, can't use that. Can't use that. Except this week.
Uh-oh.
This week, I went through the list and I was like, well, I can use that. And 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 it just kept going. I pared down this week's stories and it was hard to do. Because there were so many fucked up ones.
So what you're saying is we're working overtime?
I'm not putting on. I don't have time. If I did every single story, that would be the rest of the night. That would be the next 3 hours.
Wow.
It was amazing. I can't remember a time that I had so many that were perfectly valid and perfectly fucked up. Just to give you some examples of the stuff that isn't going to be on tonight. It's a major scandal going on in Canada right now about a conservative candidate for office who was caught on video urinating in someone's coffee cup.
Ugh.
There was a story that came out of Ireland about a man who was arrested after stalking his ex-wife, and they found on his phone fish porn.
What?
Was a man fucking a fish, Tara.
Because I was going to say, fish don't even fuck each other.
Like, no.
How fish reproduce.
There was a story about a 16-year-old whose name was...
I fuck a fish. I don't even think they have the proper parts for that.
That's never stopped people before. Fish got mouths. It's got a hole. Someone's going to stick their dick in it. That is humanity. We had a story about a 16-year-old who was found in the company of a 46-year-old in England, and he was also discovered to have 28 containers of heroin shoved up his butt that was discovered only because he was sitting awkwardly.
How many?
28! Wow. Up his butt! Kids, these are the rejects tonight, okay?
Wow.
There were many, many, many other stories tonight. So just, this is, I guess you would call this the best of the worst.
The creme de la creme of...
The creme de la crap.
There you go.
And there was a poop story that I didn't use. I got another fucking poop story. Tired of the poop.
We're not using a poop story?
We're not. Because I'm tired of the fucking poop. I had an excuse not to.
You're tired of poop?
Yes, I am sick, and it's funny for like 5 minutes, but then when it's every week, it's not funny anymore. It's like, Jesus Christ, just use the toilet like everybody else.
Listen, I'm not a doctor, but if you're tired of poop, that might be affecting your mood. That might be why Doctor Who makes you so mad.
So, all that having been said, let's begin the nonsense tonight. This is just... Here we go.
I want to rewrite Do You Want to Build a Snowman?
Do you want to do the nonsense?
I'm trying to think of the rest of the lyrics.
Each week, Catherine, the Radio Dead Air audience, go out in the worldwide interwebs, find all sorts of horrible stuff, bring it right back here for a little segment we like to call... What the fuck is wrong with you? And, okay, where do we even start? Let's get topical, shall we? So there's been a meme running around. I say meme. It's not a meme. It's a forced narrative. Forced narrative. That's what's happening. Fox News, ever since the Black Lives Matter hashtag and movement began, Fox News has been pushing back against that like a motherfucker. And especially they're trying to drum up this idea that Black Lives Matter is causing police to get murdered. There's no connection whatsoever. None whatsoever. But Fox is... So they've been featuring stories about police who are being attacked or killed in the line of duty. Which is why, ladies and gentlemen, get ready to get even more pissed. If you were pissed at the police, get ready to be more pissed. If you weren't pissed, get ready to start. This one comes to us from Boston.
Baston.
Millis officer may face charges after sparking manhunt. And this...
I saw this.
I'll let you guys... If you guys are television addicts like I am, maybe you can try and figure out how there's life imitating art. I'll see who in the channel can figure out which show this very much imitates. Small town teaming with law enforcement searching for a fugitive gunman because one searching for answers became one searching for answers after police said Thursday the officer who claimed he was fired on by a passing pickup truck had fabricated the account. Well, that's not that bad, right? No.
I mean, that's pretty bad, but...
It gets worse. The officer, 24 years old, who's working as a full-time dispatcher, part-time patrolman, was scheduled to begin training for full-time patrolman position soon. As the investigation continues, the officers said the officer would be fired and face criminal charges. The officer said the vehicle had been hit by gunfire from a white man driving a dark-colored pickup truck. The SUV, let's see, where is it? His police SUV crashed into the woods around 2:30 p.m., caught fire, and was destroyed. The officer said the vehicle had been hit by gunfire. But investigators determined the shots were fired by the officer himself, and there was no pickup truck driver.
Why
and
do that?
Mahoney's in the channel already picked this up. This exact same thing. This isn't even deviation. This exact same fucking thing happened on The Wire.
Did it really?
There was really stupid fucking cop at the time. He made a much better teacher than a cop, put it that way. Really stupid cop. Discharged, shot up his own patrol car and set it on fire.
Why?
Because he was an idiot. Except in this case, apparently what they're thinking is he did this to, you know, what is it that, it's not Munchausen syndrome, is it? You know what I'm talking about?
For attention?
Yeah, that this was some sort of Munchausen to ride the coattails of this whole war on police thing that's going on out there.
Oh. What?
Feel sorry for me because...
So he fucked up his own police cruiser.
And set it on fire and crashed it.
Somebody attacked him because he was a cop?
Yeah.
Did he injure himself in any way?
Nope. Him fine.
If you really want the sympathy, you gotta get, like, horribly disfigured or some shit.
And the problem with this is this led to a massive manhunt all over town. Cops were growing all over the fucking place trying to find this guy who didn't exist. And also at the same time...
At least he didn't do the thing that white people always fucking do and create an imaginary black man. Do you remember the woman that drowned all her kids and then...
Yes!
A black dude
in South Carolina
drowned them, and it was really her. Like, White people love to do horrible shit and then create an imaginary black guy to blame it on.
Maybe he thought when he got...
At least he created an
imaginary white guy. He created an imaginary white guy.
I mean, at least, you know.
Oh, I like JM Share of the channel. But Munchausen Syndrome. I like that. It's not Munchausen Syndrome. It's But Munchausen Syndrome. Yeah. That might be her title this week.
Here's the thing. If you're a cop, but you Munchausen gotta know. Syndrome. That the cops have ballistic experts, forensic experts. How do you think you're going to get away with this? Like, they're going to be able to figure out that the bullets that shot up your car were from your own
gun. Yeah.
They can figure that out pretty easily, actually.
Chad the Jedi, Foster's Home for Imaginary White Guys. Oh. Oh. Oh, mother, you son of a bitch. You wasted money. You ruined a fucking vehicle. Guess who's paying for that? Taxpayers.
Yeah.
They got to replace that fucking car. Apparently, at the same time, there was also a bomb threat on a nearby school. They don't know if that's related to this or not.
Oh, God. Or just, you know, an Aqua Teen Hunger Force publicity prank. We all remember that.
That shut Boston right the fuck up down.
Light brights.
Light brights shut Boston down. This, and you know what? This is not, probably not helping. Whatever your intention to improve the image of police in this country.
Here's the thing, though. You got to keep in mind, have you ever been to Boston? Here's the thing.
I haven't, actually. I haven't,
You can enjoy it. But here's the thing. Like, Manhattan is a city that is laid out very logically.
Uh-huh.
The streets are numbered. Like, avenues go one way. Streets go the other.
Savannah's the same way. It's beautiful.
Boston is designed because fuck you. There's rotaries. The streets make no sense.
Fuck yeah, that's why.
You're trying to get to, but not get there. So everybody in Boston exists in, I have to imagine, a constant state of stress and frustration already because their streets were designed by some kind of sadistic fucking clown from hell. Like, basically Pennywise from It was the city designer for Boston, I think. So yeah, every little thing is going to kind of set them off because holy shit, you can't get anywhere. And you put that city on lockdown and life just gets bad, man, because you couldn't get where you were going anyway.
This is just so, yeah, I think you kind of, so I don't think police are getting that bump that they were looking for.
Boston was actually pretty much designed by cows.
It's designed by cows.
They just paved the cow paths. The channel is telling me.
Well, now that I've touched...
That suddenly makes a lot of fucking sense.
Well, now that I've touched on one political hot button tonight, let's touch on another political hot button. Video games!
Oh, good. Something I know absolutely nothing about.
Well, don't worry. The people who made this video game know absolutely nothing about video games, too.
Oh, God. Is this the thing? I don't want to talk about the thing.
Do you remember edutainment when we were kids?
What?
Number Munchers and Oregon Trail. Do you remember all those games?
I fucking loved Oregon Trail.
Do you remember Number Munchers?
No.
Do you remember Number Munchers? I killed at Number Munchers. But you remember those little, they take us to the computer lab in elementary school.
We had a game where we had to solve mysteries. You had to find motive, opportunity, and means.
Yeah.
And solve, like, little crime mysteries.
And, what was it, Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego and all those.
Yeah.
Had them on the Apple IIe's that they had in the
Commodore 64, .8, .1.
These were edutainment. These were games that were designed to help teach kids shit. And you know what? They actually did teach it. Number Munchers actually did help me with math. It was very useful.
I played Number Munchers, and that sounds weirdly dirty. All Oregon Trail taught me was be a banker. don't fjord the river, and someone's going to die of dysentery.
Well, you know, that was for us. That was 30 years ago, if not.
We mad old.
Yeah. Well, things have changed a lot since those days.
Half the channel, we could be their parents. Yep.
Shut up. After outcry, edutainment game removes slave Tetris mode.
I don't want to do the thing.
A recent 25% off sale on the Steam version of Playing History 2 Slave Trade brought the game back into the limelight, especially its trailer video, which showcased a slave Tetris mode. On Monday, following wider reactions from users on Steam and social media, the creator removed that mode from both the trailer and the game itself, explaining on Twitter and Steam that, quote, "It was perceived to be extremely insensitive by some people."
You think?
See, and I've watched Let's Plays of this thing, which Jim Sterling did a Let's Play. You should check it out on YouTube. I might even actually link it to this video so you can see what we're talking about here. It's, this game is awful. Now, everyone got up in arms about the slave Tetris thing. And here's how this mode works. In order, this was supposedly the creator's intention. Air fucking quotes. Their intention was to exemplify the horrors of the slave trade by showing people how tightly packed slaves were into the vessels that took them from Africa to the New World.
Because that was the most horrifying thing about the slave trade. Not that I'm saying that's not horrifying, but like... Yeah. You're definitely focusing on minutia there.
So
like a small part of a big picture.
So in order to demonstrate how awful this was, there's a Tetris mini game in which you have to see how many slaves you can cram into the boat, and the slaves, as you can see in the picture here, are in Tetris form. Now, keep in mind, they're supposed to be teaching you about horrors, while at the same time, a time-traveling mouse in a jaunty hat, and for some fucking reason, a dragon, are helping you.
What? Really?
Yes. In this game, you play a slave who works for the cabin, and the little time-traveling mouse gives you chrono goggles so you can look around and see disturbances to the timeline.
What?
Yes!
So not only are you stacking people.
Yes.
Tetris people. Vival is helping you?
From the future. Vival of the Time Police. Time Police Mouse.
Why the Time Police?
Tara, I am opening my mouth and every time words come out, it's nothing but crazy.
What the fuck are the Time Police?
What the fuck is just...
From what time period are... Dragons.
And notice, the mouse gives no fucks about the slave trade.
In what time period were dragons real?
But the mouse does really care if an AK-47 shows up in ye olden times. That's what the mouse is really... Fuck the slave trade.
Is there an AK-47 in
there? There's an AK-40. There's a Klansman hood in this game. This game is insane, Tara.
Why is there an AK-47 in this game?
To show you that it doesn't belong in this time period, but that the slave trade still exists, just in a different form. I don't know, Tara! I keep talking and I keep making crazy!
I'm so confused. What is this supposed to teach children?
To make it even worse, this Tetris mode you see here, you're scored. You're given a score. And if you score too low, you're given a chance to try again and get a higher score of squishing in more slaves.
This is kind of like if in the Oregon Trail, every time someone in your party got dysentery or bit by a snake or something, you were given the option to kill them. Actually, no, this is way worse than that, because that would at least be a moral dilemma.
The game,
I don't know what this is.
The game's Steam page was updated on Monday with the following note. Quote, apologies to people who was offended. To people who was offended. Not people who were, people who was. From a history teaching game. Apologies to people.
It's not a grammar teaching game.
Apologies to people who was offended by us using game mechanics to underline the point of how inhumane slavery was. The goal was to enlighten and educate people, not to get sidetracked discussing a small 15-second part of the game.
No.
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 No, no, no. No. No.
The grammar teaching game is about Hitler.
Oh, also, let's blow your mind a little bit more. Okay, there's a part of the game where you, and then I get, this game is made for children, supposedly. You are supposed to play this little boy slave who's in service to the captain, and you have, and they're running out of food on the ship. So you have to go and talk to the doctor on the ship and make a list of the 20 most expendable slaves to throw overboard.
That's a joke, right? You're joking.
No.
That's not a thing.
I'm not joking.
I refuse to believe that that's a thing.
I'll link to it.
Don't you fucking dare.
It's not a joke. You are a child and you have to decide who lives and who dies. Playing history!
That's just preparing kids for Obama's death panels. They're just trying to be responsible. Because eventually those will be the only jobs left on the death panels deciding who lives and who dies.
And you know what, Tara? You know what? That was only our second story, Tara.
Can we go now? Can we go? I don't want to talk about the slave trading mouse anymore.
Do you really? Okay, all right. Let's move along. So, you know what? I have no lead into this. We'll just jump right into it.
Oh, good.
Fake ultrasounds, fake bellies, and fakeababy.com gets Michigan teen into non-fake trouble.
What?
Need a bun in the oven, says the website fakeababy.com? We can help. Billing itself as home of the $9.95 fake ultrasound, it purports to sell the best gag gifts on Earth, according to Fox 2 News and Wyandotte, Michigan. Nobody in that town thinks it's funny that a teenage girl pretended for months that she was pregnant with triplets, no less, using fake-a-baby products. As word of her impending good fortune spread on Facebook, through a group she joined called Moms of Triplets, gifts started pouring in. A church got involved, a nonprofit group in Dearborn chipped in, and relatives threw her a baby shower. She got tons of help, Jessica Adams, an aunt, told the station. The gifts, they couldn't even open at the shower. There was too much. She looked pregnant, too. Her abdomen expanded appropriately. She had ultrasound pictures to confirm the triplets. And her 16-year-old boyfriend, informed that he was about to become a father of three, was excited, or at least said he was, but also a little scared. I started looking for jobs the best I could, he told the station. The young man's mother started to get suspicious, however, when she could not locate the doctor who was supposedly tending to her son's girlfriend. And then things got really strange when, even after 10 months, not a single baby, let alone three of them, arrived. 10 months? So,
multiple births almost never go fully to term, let alone over term. And they don't let you go to 10 months anymore.
Nope.
They induce you after like 2 weeks. You go more than a week overdue and they start talking about shooting you full of Pitocin and or cutting you open. There's no such thing as a 10-month baby anymore. I'm not sure there's ever been such a thing as 10-month triplets. But wait, did she start a business about faking pregnancies?
No, she just used the site. The site exists. Oh. This teenager just availed herself of the site and...
to fake a pregnancy to get what? Get free shit?
Yeah, a fuckload of free shit. And donations and presents. And this poor kid.
Classic internet. You know how many people have faked, like, their own deaths on the internet, their own debilitating diseases, just for sympathy and whatever? Like, this is basically a classic catfish, except she did it in real life.
And this poor, the poor boyfriend.
I know.
This poor 16-year-old kid who one day is just like...
I mean, the good news is you're not a 16-year-old father.
Well, yeah, I just feel sorry. He's like, well, I started looking for jobs. At least he tried to step up.
Yeah.
He
tried to do the right thing. Good for you. Now you're off the hook.
Jareth in the channel says 19 fake kids and not counting.
What was her plan?
What was she going to do when she hit that? Was she going to be like, you know, was she going to go buy some babies?
I mean, obviously she didn't have one because she was still rocking pregnant with triplets at 10 months. And that's not a thing that happens.
No. They
honestly, like, by the time it was 9 months, people should have started asking questions because multiple births don't really carry the term. They usually don't. They usually go a little early.
This is just...
Oh, my God, that's right. We have an expert.
Who?
Mike. Mike's a triplet.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, Mike. My producer, Mike.
He says he and his brothers were 6 or 7 weeks early.
Yeah, Mike. Those of you who don't know, my producer, Mike Gearman, there's three of him.
More of him.
There's three of him.
Yeah. Think about that for a minute, guys.
The guy who requests three all that horrible shit.
And God is trying to burn California off the... God's up there like, I can't believe I made three of that one. Burn it all. Nuke it from orbit. It's the only way to be sure.
There's three of him. So yeah, this...
The triplets don't go 10 fucking months. You would explode.
This just does not seem like a good thing. The wares on fakeababy.com, they sell fake silicone, fake pregnancy belly, fake breast push-ups, fake ultrasounds.
Because, I mean, I get... I'm about to sound crazy. In a weird way, I can understand chicks faking a pregnancy if they're really fucking psychotic and trying to hang on to a man. I do not recommend that. Don't do that. It's crazy.
No.
There's, you know, shut up. But the key to that is faking a miscarriage early on.
Don't help, Tara.
Otherwise, at some point, you have to produce a baby. Like, by the time you are as big as the woman in that picture, you're probably not just going to miscarry. And even if you do, there's going to be a fetus that has to be removed and dealt with. Like, after a certain point in the fake pregnancy, you have to figure out how you're going to produce a baby.
Wait,
there alive.
Not necessarily. A story about some Chinese women who, in an effort to get seats on crowded Beijing subways, used fake pregnant bellies purchased from fakeapregnancy.com.
Oh, fucking smart.
Ruse came to an end when one of the fake stomachs fell to the ground in front of some subway passengers.
I get that. All right, I get that. Although that wouldn't work in New York, because on the subway they're like...
They don't give a shit. They don't give a shit. Oh, so we have more. We have...
But yeah, if you're trying to trick your boyfriend, like, you need to have a tragic miscarriage early on, because otherwise you're going to have to produce a baby. And that's not as easy as you think without actually getting pregnant.
So we're going big this week. We're going big. We've got more on the going big. And you know what? If we're going big, we've had people who have defaced all sorts of things. Stores, other people.
There should be a fake baby Tetris game.
But this week, if we're gonna go big, we've got to go big with defacing a national fucking landmark. Man accused of carving name into wall inside the Alamo. Julio Perez, 22, is accused of causing about $250,000 in damage to the Alamo by carving his name into an interior wall with a key. According to a statement issued Friday morning by Mark Adkins, chief of the Alamo Rangers, an Alamo tour guide noticed Perez as he was carving his name into a wall inside an area of the shrine known as the Monk's Barrel Room. Incident happened around 4:30 p.m. Perez tried to get
Burial room, not barrel room.
burial. Sorry.
It's not a fucking distillery.
Oh, but if it were.
I mean, it's Texas, so I can see where you would make that mistake.
The Alamo Fort and Draft House. Anyway, the incident happened around 4:30 Thursday. Perez tried to get away when confronted, but was arrested by Alamo Rangers. Police say that the carving was of the suspect's name, Julio, and it measured about 3 inches by 1 inch. While the damage is small in size, it was a big deal to Friday morning visitors. He said historic.
Is this really the first time this has happened?
Apparently.
That kind of surprises me.
You know, if you're
If there's
going.
one thing Americans are good at, it's fucking up the nice things. Like, don't you tend to assume that all the national landmarks are secretly covered in little dicks drawn in Sharpie?
You're going to deface a national landmark? Don't personalize that
Yeah,
shit!
don't leave your name. Don't
What?
sign your work.
What the fuck did you think was gonna. Wasn't me.
Especially not in fucking Texas. They take that shit serious there.
Yeah. That is. That's like taking a dump in the Holy
The
Grail,
Texans
man.
are so mad at me right now.
Why are they mad at you?
I don't know, I guess the distillery joke?
Mean, well, no, this isn't the first time that the Alamo has been, had defaced. I mean,
I know the
famously.
Alamo is a big deal in Texas. I know, like this is a thing. Like you don't fuck with it. But I'm kind of surprised that this is news because I feel like anywhere that you're not constantly being watched for Americans, idiot Americans, is just su subject to graffiti.
Idiot Americans. Oh my God, we have African Americans, we have Native Americans, we have idiot Americans.
They are not a protected
No,
class.
thank God. Remember the Julio because he will end worse than the
So
Alamo.
I'm not saying it to be insulting. I'm just saying I'm kind of surprised that this doesn't happen more often.
Well, they were
Because you
mentioning
can't possibly watch people all the time.
earlier, most famously, Ozzy Osbourne pissed on the Alamo. Literally, just quite
Like,
peed
I'm
on the
sure
Alamo.
Alcatraz is covered in fucking graffiti. Because you can't watch everybody all the time, you know?
250.
People are assholes.
And due to the amount, it's a felony charge. Why your own name of all fucking
Write your buddy's
things?
name.
Hey.
Name of the ex you're still bitter at. Like,
Yo, Gene, do you spell your name with a G or a J? No reason, no reason.
don't worry about it. I was just wondering for your birthday card.
No reason, man. No reason. Oh, for fuck's sake. 250. It's a felony because it was damage in excess of $150,000. So, you idiot. Why would you do this? What
Yo,
was.
why is it necessary?
I mean, what the fuck is the. What? Oh, Jed the Jedi. Not Julio.
Definitely not Julio.
What is the upside to this? What is the pay? I mean, if you ever go back and try to say, see, I did that, you're already.
I mean, I don't get, like, I get, like, graffiti artists and taggers because they're putting some effort into it, you know. That's an art form, I get it. If you're just a fucking idiot with, like, a ballpoint or a key carving your name into random shit, I don't understand the point. I was in a bar once in New York City, and in the ladies' room, on the wall in Sharpie was written, OK Cupid sucks. Why that graffiti? And what's funny is I was on an OK Cupid date at the time.
That's why that graffiti, Tara. Someone else was in the exact same position you were.
Of all the things to write on a bathroom wall, why that? Why was that the thought that came to mind?
Well, we'll just keep moving along. This one, I will make a note. Some people actually were hurt in this next story, but I do feel like we have to cover it because, Jesus, fuck, what the fuck is... All right, so West Point apparently has an annual tradition. They do a great big pillow fight.
Yeah.
Near graduation. Which sounds, you know, okay, sure.
What branch of the military is West Point?
Army.
So these are your people. We can blame Dan for whatever happens next.
Dan's already back there going, fuck.
Damn it.
And you know, the pillow fight seems like, okay, fine.
Harmless fun. Except
from the Department of This Is Why We Can't Have Nice Things. West Point cadets hurt in violent pillow fight.
Yeah.
Pillow fight at the United States Military Academy at West Point turned so violent that it caused concussions in 24 cadets. The August.
Are you sure about this?
I still have stories from the military that can't be told.
Did you catch that?
He has stories in the military that can't be told. The August 20 pillow fight, an annual tradition at the prestigious academy and a way for first-year cadets to have some fun after a rigorous month of summer training, also resulted in other serious injuries, broken nose, dislocated shoulder, a hairline cheekbone fracture.
Cheekbone fracture? That's literally a broken face.
Your face is broken.
They can't put a fucking cast on that, by the way.
Nope, you just gotta wait for it to heal.
Just think about not being able to move the entire side of your face without excruciating pain.
Yeah. In total, 30 cadets were evaluated by medical personnel. Four were released with no injuries, and no cadets left the academy due to their injuries. Listen to this. According to the Times, the class spirit-building activity turned bloody when cadets at the taxpayer-funded academy put hard objects believed to be helmets in their pillowcases. So what happened was the entire class was going to have this fun pillow fighting thing, and some people there decided, hey, you know what we're going to do? We're going to put steel helmets in the pillowcases. Because fuck you.
This is what happens when you let Jack Nicholson's character from A Few Good Men run the student activities board.
What is happening at West Point?
Why? I don't understand why that's fun. I don't see how that's a party.
Yeah, hey, you know what? Instead of us all just going around hitting each other with pillows,
bludgeon the fuck out of each other for real.
Can you imagine the poor guys who were out there did not know anything else was going on, and all of a sudden, kabam! Your face doesn't work anymore.
I have to admit my focus is a little divided because I want to know what kind of stories from the military my boyfriend can't tell.
So what the fuck is wrong with these kids? Full metal pillow.
Yeah. Like, what is... It's supposed to be good, harmless fun, and you made it shitty, harmful, not fun. How about next time we all just go out and take our weapons and shoot each other? Like, why?
Yeah.
You take the pointedly harmless fun and make it bludgeoning.
Listen to this.
Fun, bludgeoning. Not the same.
Punishment could be dismissal from the academy, or they could be eliminated and permitted back a year later. If they do not dismiss anyone,
or they could be doing push-ups until they die.
Punishment would include restricted movement, free time, and march punishment tours. Hey, you know what happens in the really real world? If I were to, say, take a pillow and put a steel thingy in it and go out in the street and hit someone in the face and break it, do you know what happened to me?
You'd go to jail.
I'd go to jail! Why the fuck are they not going to jail?
Oh, they're just kids and boys will be boys and all that happy horse shit.
Fuck you, jail!
Like, are we doing the football player story?
What one?
There's these two fucking asshole high school football players in Texas didn't like a call the ref made. So on the next play, instead of going after the other team, two fucking players took out the ref on the field during play, put him in the hospital.
Jail!
Did from school, and people were complaining that the ref wants to file charges because he's going to ruin their lives.
Fuck you, jail! Fuck you, jail!
Yeah, that is true. Neil Silverthorne makes a good point. They're not under civilian law. They're under the military.
Yeah, you know what the military should do? The military got jails.
Well, yeah.
Talk to Miss Manning about they got jails. She's sitting in one right now. They got jails. Fuck you, jail.
Fuck you, jail. Nash Bozard, 2015.
Fuck you, jail.
That can go in your presidential.
Finally, the last story tonight, as if it couldn't get any fucking worse. Oh my fucking God. What could be worse than a harmless pillow fight that turns into a fucking smackdown that sends 24 people to the hospital? What could be fucking worse? I'm going to go ahead of time. No children were injured in this story. Thank God. Everyone's fine. I'll put that ahead of time. Everyone's fine. This one has got, if we have a Hall of Fame, or is it a Hall of Shame? I don't know what it is for headlines.
We should have a Hall of Fame.
For headlines, this one would definitely rank as a contender. Daycare apologizes after workers incite children to scuffle in fight club.
Yeah.
Daycare fight club.
Those words do not belong together.
Hello, people of the internet.
Whoa.
How are you?
Ha, fucking autoplay.
Stop, shush.
Cranford, New Jersey.
I didn't realize this was local.
Officials at a daycare center are apologizing to parents after two workers were accused of instigating scuffles among the young children as part of a fight club. Workers were charged Tuesday with child abuse. The Light Bridge Academy Center in Cranford said in a statement it was, quote, shocked and saddened. They're always shocked and saddened. Have you noticed that?
Yeah.
Shocked, saddened, not really very effective. Center officials said they learned of the allegations in mid-August and suspended the workers, Erica Kenny, 22, of Cranfield, and Shanice White, 28, of Roselle. Both were fired a short time later and due to be arraigned Friday. The center's been cooperating with the prosecutor's office, which investigated the case. Prosecutors and police say Kenny and White instigated the fight club among children ages 4 to 6. 4 to 6. On at least one day last month, authorities also said Kenny recorded videos of the fights and shared the clips with several friends on social media.
Remember when they used to sell those DVDs of homeless people getting in fights?
Yeah.
Like they'd pay two homeless dudes
to fight
$4 to beat the shit out of each other. And that was fucking horrible because you're exploiting homeless people and getting the shit beat out of them when they can't afford to go to a hospital and generally just not treating them like human people. And that was horrible. These are toddlers. Like, at least they were grown people capable of making their own decisions. Even though it was under compromised circumstances, these are toddlers.
Retro K283. First rule of daycare fight club is fuck you, jail.
Yeah. Like, activities for a daycare. Snack time, nap time.
Not fight club.
Limbo, sprinkler.
Not fight club.
Reading. Not Fight Club.
Investigators say about a dozen boys and girls were shown in the clip shoving one another to the ground and trying to hit one another. Children apparently did not suffer any serious injuries.
What were they telling the parents if their kid came home with like a black eye or something?
The kids will be kids.
Like, oh, little Jimmy fell off the swing.
That's right, Jimmy, you fell, right? Motherfucking you assholes. You tremendous... gigantic, you assholes!
And I mean, fuck, like, it's scary having a kid today.
Yes.
I mean, I can't imagine being a parent in today's world. It's a terrifying thing to have to raise a tiny little person in today's world. Like, you can't fucking trust anybody. All the food is gonna give you cancer eventually. The planet's going to shit. They might just get shot because, like, it's a scary world to send a little tiny person out into. There should be at least, like, the people that you are paying to keep them safe and reasonably happy while you are at work. You should at least think they're not going to make another kid beat the shit out of my kid for their amusement.
And how can...
That's like the bare minimum of what you should expect.
How can a person devise this? You know what? Kids are not my favorite people. I'll be the first to admit this. Kids are not my favorite people. But even I wouldn't be sitting there looking at kids and going, you know what would be funny? You know why? Because it's not funny!
I mean, my sister and I tried real hard to kill each other our whole childhood. We beat the shit out of each other to the point where my mom used to rotate emergency rooms. Because she worked for Child Protective Services and knew that we would get taken away between all the stupid shit we did to ourselves and the stupid shit we did to each other.
What else? You busted your teeth.
My sister threw me down the stairs and I swallowed my two front baby teeth and ripped my lip off.
Right, right, right.
I broke her arm twice out of the total, seven times she broke her arm. My other sister, I got mad at her, so I grabbed her earring and ripped it until it came through her ear, like just ripped it out. Nancy has a scar on her face from my fingernail. Nancy clawed me in the eye and scratched my cornea.
Y'all did not fuck around.
And then Nancy and I became baton twirlers. And we had projectile weapons. And it just all went to hell.
Y'all did not fuck around in your family.
My mom was a social worker who worked at Child Protective Service. And she knew. She was like, nobody would believe that I'm not beating you. So we used to rotate hospitals because she didn't want us to get taken away. And that was only for our own amusement.
No, just, I do not, you are bad people. This has just been douche, this has been like wall-to-wall douchebag this week. I can't handle it. You are.
Yes, my sisters and I get along quite fine now. We haven't tried to kill each other in at least 20 years.
Douchebag doesn't sum it up. Twat waffle does not sum it up. There is not, I'm at a loss.
How do you fuck with, like... I know, like, kids can be frustrating as shit. Like, they're not reasonable. There's no reasoning.
Nope.
They're little tiny crazy people and you can't reason with them. And sometimes they're really frustrating, but that's not their fault.
No.
They're literally unable to be reasonable yet. And the answer to that is not to make them beat the shit out of each other.
I mean, Jesus Christ, Anna.
You would think that would go without saying.
And you're putting that shit on the internet.
Oh, well, of course. Like, you got to put everything on Facebook. You got to put all your stupid,
well, no,
stupid, illegal shit on Facebook.
Here's, they tried to be smart. Smart. You know what? They put it on Snapchat. Because they believed it would disappear.
Yeah.
They staked their hopes on Snapchat. Unfortunately, someone got it off Snapchat and recorded it before they could delete it.
Right, because that's a thing that you can do.
Note to my viewers, if you think Snapchat will make the horrible thing go away, Snapchat does not make the horrible thing
go away. Nothing on the internet is ever really gone. And that is why 20 years from now, nobody will be able to run for public office.
So what do we learn this week? Children are not there to amuse yourself with.
It's kind of like fish your friends, not food.
Yes. Yes. Kind of.
Yeah.
We've learned.
Story time is not the WWE training ground.
We learned that when everyone's trying to have a good time, someone will go out of their fucking way to ruin it just because.
Bashing people's skulls in, like, why is that fun?
We've learned that it's not a good idea to deface a national landmark, but it's an even worse idea to personalize your defacement.
And to deface the fucking Alamo.
Yeah, you. I do not want to, like, be
Julio. I've never even been to Texas, and I know Texans don't fuck around with that shit.
I don't want to be Julio right now.
That's not okay.
Julio does not want to be Julio,
like,
right
now. Why don't you come up to New York and deface the 9/11 memorial while you're at it?
We've learned that faking a pregnancy, you gotta have an end game on that shit.
You need an exit strategy.
You need an end game. We've learned that you learn nothing about history from slave Tetris.
Or choosing who's gonna die.
What did you do today, Timmy? I decided who lives and who dies.
Or helping your mouse friend hunt for AK-47s.
In the distant past.
In the programming of this game. Like, did you just do all the fucking drugs and then decide to write a history game?
And finally, we learned tonight. Do not try to fake an assault on yourself if you're the police. Because the police will find that out. You cost...
Police buy an illegal gun and shoot up your police car with that.
Don't help.
Don't shoot it up with your service.
Don't help. No. No. Do not help.
Like, how fucking dumb do you have to be?
Do not help.
Shoot up your squad car with your service revolver. They're going to figure that out.
Very dumb.
Very dumb.
Fuck you, jail.
Is that this week's title?
Yes. Fuck you, jail. No, I can't use that one. But still, fuck you, jail.